Today on Trek Wars, we are going to discuss the Klingon Bird of Prey. We will discuss its weapons, its defensive capabilities, why the ship was built, its advantages and disadvantages. First off, we'll have to discuss the fact there is no set size for the Bird of Prey. The Bird of Prey only refers to the actual shape of the ship and design. The standard Bird of Prey consists of two heavy Klingon disruptor cannons and one photon torpedo launcher. It is noted that sometimes the photon torpedo launcher is moved and removed, and a central device is used for scouting missions, allowing for a more advanced sentry equipment. Next, we'll take a look at the Klingon disruptors. We see that the Klingon vessel started off with 16,250 terawatts of damage. There was a modified version later on, which consisted of 24,375. And there's also an even newer version, which we see during the DS9 and TNG era, which has a 35,500 terawatt disruptors. The 16,250 was the disruptors that were used during the Star Trek movies, as well as the weapons that would have fought against Captain Kirk in the Constitution class. The Klingon Bird of Prey is not standardized by any means. Depending on your house and the value of your house depends on the type of weapons you'd be given. Most old Klingon Birds of Prey have 16,250 terawatt weapons. Some of the mid-range vessels have 24,375, which are seen mostly during the Jem'Hadar and TNG era. The most advanced Bird of Prey ships, which you see towards the end of the Dominion War, consist of disruptor cannons of 32,500. We'll take a look at this scene right here to show you the 16,250 disruptors. You can barely count the blast compared to the 195,000 defensive value of the Jem'Hadar fighter. It tells how powerful that particular Klingon Bird of Prey was. And that's why I gave the old Klingon Bird of Prey the 16,250 terawatt weapons, because this is the weakest of the disruptors that I see during the TNG era or during any of the Star Trek era movies, episodes, or anything of that nature. Next, we'll discuss the shields and hulls. Now, like I said, the Klingon Bird of Prey, we've seen the Klingon Bird of Prey be able to take at least two photon torpedoes before it died. We can also take a look at the Defiant attacking Birds of Prey to give you an idea of how strong they are. As you can see in this scene right here, two photon torpedoes hit the hull directly, and it doesn't destroy the vessel. So we know the ship is extremely badly damaged from the movie, but at minimum it can at least take two photon torpedoes. Next, we'll take a look at the defensive value of the Klingon Birds of Prey seen during the DS9 era. So we've seen the Defiant destroy Klingon Birds of Prey, and we also see the Jem'Hadar attack Klingon Birds of Prey, and we see all kinds of different stats. And here we're going to take a look at those stats right now. So as you can see, the oldest one is 390 during Kirk's era, 585 for DS9, 650,000 for DS9 era as well. And the TNG has the Kvort, which we see here, at 1,170,000. Alright, so if you go back in time, you watch the TNG episode that has Worf aboard the Bird of Prey with his brother. As you see in this fight scene, it takes a photon torpedo right there, and then two torpedoes actually, and then it takes actually 18 disruptors from the first Bird of Prey and 10 disruptors from the second Bird of Prey, and then four more during the scenes where the ship is shaking and doing all that other stuff. So altogether, you can ascertain that the defensive value of the ship is at least 1,170,000. So I would guess that the shields are around 812,500 with a hull of 357,500. It's also noted that that Bird of Prey is the largest version, named as the Kvort, and it consists of four large disruptor cannons and two torpedo launchers. It is noted that there is an alternate version in the alternate universe of the Kvort class, which is 715,000, which is seen during this episode. I don't know if this exists in the Prime universe or not, but I figured I would just mention it. Next, we'll discuss the lore of the bird of prey. So first off, the bird of prey was an advanced technology during its time. The ship typically would sneak up on ships and destroy them from behind, like we'll see here. The ship is relatively powerful for a ship of its size. It may not be able to take that much damage, but it was still effective. It would sneak attacks, get behind vessels and destroy them. It had very fast disruptors. The ship is very small compared to other ships, but it does have a high energy output level for its weapons compared to ships of its size, as we'll see right here. The bird of prey was basically designed out of necessity. The Katanga is falling too far behind the Excelsior class starships. And so newer, larger ships were created based on the successful bird of prey, which were the Kvort. The Kvort stayed in commission for a very long time, but eventually was replaced by the Volca class cruiser. When you look at the Klingon designs, the Kvort is not as optimized as the smaller versions. They seem to be a little less powerful for ships of their size compared to the counterparts of the bird of prey. The bird of prey could typically, three of them could take on an Excelsior class starship by itself, and it would take at least three Kvorts, which are almost the same size as the Enterprise, to take on one Galaxy class starship. So you can see the Kvort was significantly weaker. Next, we'll take a look at some of the graphs that I had created with some of the data tables showing you how powerful the ships are compared to other ships. So one of the things that you notice about this ship is the Bird of Prey is significantly less firepower than, would say, the Katanga. But it has have shielding around the same, but it's significantly weaker hull. But the ship is significantly smaller and takes much, much smaller crew and much smaller amount of resources. And it doesn't fall that far behind in efficiency. So it makes sense why the Katanga was phased out and the Bird of Prey took over. You could probably build three or four Birds of Prey for the price of one or two Katangas, and three Birds of Prey could easily take on an Excelsior-class starship and destroy it. And it would be only like maybe a fourth or half the size of those ships, and the cost value is significantly low, and then the crew level was probably what made the ship the most efficient. You know, a ship like the Excelsior is looking at 200 to 500 member crew, and Bird of Prey is 12. If you lost three or four Birds of Prey, it would have no effect on your overall crew or morale that much. But when you lose ships like the Katanga is like around 250 crew. That's a lot of warriors wasted. That's one of the extreme advantages of this ship. The disruptor cannons versus disruptors are significantly faster shooting, but do cost more power. So one of the things that is noted about this ship is it doesn't seem to utilize its photon torpedoes that much. And the reason for that is photon torpedoes use a lot of power. And those disruptors use a lot of power too, so they're forced to pick or choose, and on a point scale value, the disruptors pay off better. Alright, next we're going to compare the Klingon Bird of Prey directly to the Katanga. So the first thing we're looking at is the power of the disruptors. As you can see, they're both 16,250. The next thing we look at is the weapons. We know that the disruptor cannons on this vessel, if we just give them a 1 point scale, and this vessel carries two, which would be 32,500. We look at the Katanga, it has six disruptors, so it would give it a value of 97,500. Now we need to take in consideration the volley level. We know that the Katanga does only three per volley, so that would be 292,500. Now we'll compare that directly to the Borel. The Borel Klingon Bird of Prey does 6, so that brings its disruptor ability up to 195,000. Alright, next we're going to compare the shields, the hull, the full defense, and size. Now, when we look at the shields, we see the vessels during this time period were carrying the same shield matrix. Now, when we look at the hull, we see a serious difference. We see the Katanga has got a significantly stronger hull than the small Bird of Prey. Now, we can also look at the full defensive value. We see the full defensive value is that much higher. So we see that the Katanga is only slightly stronger than the Borel. Now, when we look at the size of the ship, this is where the big comparison comes in. So we see that the size of the Katanga is 760,000. The Borel is only 263,000. So we can see that the Bird of Prey is about one third the size of the Katanga. Now, on the bottom of the scale, you'll see that it says Volley. What that represents is the full defensive capability of the Katanga using its 3 photonic torpedo launcher as well as the 6 disruptor volley of 3. And then we look at the Bird of Prey, we see the Bird of Prey is capable of launching only one torpedo, but then has disruptor cannons capable of launching 6 blasts per volley. So then we look at that final ratio, we see that the Katanga is 487,500. We compare it to the Bird of Prey, which is 260,000, which is almost slightly less than half. Now, if we look at the components of building this ship, we're looking at just resources, we see that you could build 3 Birds of Prey for the price of 1 Katanga. And this is where the Bird of Prey comes into part as being the better of the two. Now to explain just a little bit of the lore. So one of you are probably wondering, why did I use the whole value of 65,000 Bird of Prey when we know from the movie where we see the Bird of Prey was first encountered that it had a much stronger hull value, which is probably more equivalent to that of the Katanga, the 195, which is equivalent to 3 torpedoes. We know that that's what we see when we first see the Bird of Prey. The reason I was using this comparison is that Bird of Prey isn't the most standardized version. The most standardized version of the Bird of Prey, the one that was mass-produced, the Borel, was actually not that prototype or those beginning prototypes, but was the smaller Borel. So the smaller Borel in the beginning carried the 195,000 terawatt shield, and then was only the whole value was only 65,000. It was smaller than the other Borel that we had seen in the movies. The one that you do see that gets blown up, you see it in one of the Star Trek movies where the Enterprise D is being attacked and it's being blown up and it's bypassing its shields, and then that ship cloaks and then its shields are down and then it takes one torpedo before it dies. And so that's the one I was using because it was an old, outdated ship, and we know that that was one of the ships that was mass produced. And when we think of the Klingon Bird of Prey or the Scout is actually the smaller version that's 65,000, but it was carrying the same payload of weapons as its larger cousin, obviously the other one is bigger and more surface area made it stronger. So the next thing is we're going to explain why the Klingon Empire used so many different versions of the same ship, with only different sizes. The reason for this is the Klingon Empire had suffered a major destruction of its Praxis moon, which was a primary source for dilithium and for ship production. This had put the Klingon Empire basically bankrupt, and so they didn't have the money or economics to build new ships or prototypes really, so they were forced to use what they had. And so what they had was the effective Klingon Bird of Prey, which was significantly smaller and cheaper than the Katanga to produce, and so they just made the stagnation of the Klingon Empire led them to building the large version of the Bird of Prey known as the Kvort. The Kvort was not very effective for a ship of its size, as seen during the Next Generation, but this was the only thing the Klingon Empire was able to produce that could compete with Excelsior class starships. The truce between the Kitamura Guard with the Federation and the Klingon Empire led to the Klingon Empire being given technology from the Federation. One of the primary things the Klingon Empire used was large capital ship designs. The Federation had more advanced shipbuilding technology than the Klingons had, and this led to the Klingon Empire adopting Federation technology. The hybrid version of Klingon and Federation technology led to the Volca class cruiser. The Volca class cruiser was the newest warship of the Klingon Empire and had replaced the Borel as well as the Kvort class as the primary warship of the Empire. During the time period of the Dominion War, the Klingon Birds of Prey were delegated to scouting missions, hit and run, or ship support roles. The vessel was no longer considered a mainstream warship of the Klingon Empire.